automatically have thought to yourselves of the so-called Twitter revolutions. Do you remember that? All right, so the Twitter revolutions, the idea is that in Iran, in Egypt, in Syria, in Tunisia, and so on, all these revolutionary movements had come about thanks to the communications technologies networking the young, educated middle class so they could rise up against their old regimes. Now, this was bullshit at the time. It would probably be even more bullshit now for various reasons I'm going to go into, but one reason it was bullshit at the time was that hardly anybody in these countries was even on the internet, and fewer were making use of these social industry platforms. I'll come back to why I'm talking about social industry in a moment. The author of the phrase Twitter revolutions was actually the State Department. And the reason why they came up with this phrase was because they were trying to flatter Twitter. They were trying to persuade them, oh, keep your platform open while the green movement's going on, because we think this could actually be quite useful. It's a Twitter revolution, you know. And they bought that shit. And some people in the media bought it as well. Who would have thought that our media would be so gullible? That was the origin of a lot of sort of liberal cyber utopianism. The screen's gone off. Hold on just a second. All right.